Now, today we start next part of unit number 4, that is electronic instrumentation. Now, in the previous lecture, we go through the three different block diagrams and their working principle, that is digital multimeter, function generator and digital storage oscilloscope. Now, today we'll start with power oscilloscope. Actually, this is a power scope. Little bit changes are there in a power scope as shown in the block diagram. The block diagram is consist of attenuator and isolator. Two channel inputs are provided, electronic switch is given, display portion is given, slope, filter, ramp generator, and we'll get a signal. Now, what is the function of a power scope? A power scope is an oscilloscope that is designed to measure or display the voltages and waveform in a low power and high power circuit simultaneously. So that's why we are utilizing the two inputs for channel 1 also as well as for channel 2 also. A power scope is a dual trace oscilloscope. It means it can display two waveforms simultaneously. A power scope incorporates very special safety feature such as a fully grounded front panel and controls to minimize the operator's shock hazard. So ground terminal is provided, and power scope have the ability to withstand a transient voltage up to 2 kV at all the vertical amplifier inputs. Now this is regarding to the power scope. So if basically we deal with the attenuator and isolator, what is mean by the attenuator? Attenuation is a general term that refers to any reduction in the strength of a signal. An isolator means it will make the difference between input and output signal, or in a simple way we can say isolator is make the difference between the two signals. So this is the main blocks of the power scope. So in short, the working of power scope is nothing but the inputs are provided at channel 1 and channel 2 to the attenuator and isolator block. Then it's provided to the electronic switch and it will display the signal. Now, normal oscilloscope has two input terminals, main and ground. The ground terminal is always at zero potential. Power scope is used to observe the waveforms of a signal in any branch of the circuit. Even though none of the terminal of that branch is connected to ground, we are able to display that signal. Power scope is also used for a high voltage circuit to observe high amplitude waveforms. The block diagram shows that power scope is similar to normal oscilloscope except its input circuit. The input circuit consists of attenuator and isolator. The attenuator attenuates signal and reduces its amplitude so that it can be observed on CRT screen. The isolator isolates both the input terminals from external high potential and external circuit from the CRO ground. The vertical input ranges is from 50 mV per division to 500 V per division. The trace is switched in two channels at the rate of 100 kHz. AC mode bandwidth is 2 Hz to 15 MHz. It have a wide range of measurement capability, compact design, lightweight and high safety. If there is a question to explain the block diagram of power scope, you have to draw this block diagram, explain one by one what is mean by a simple oscilloscope and what is the difference between the power scope, that as we discussed, that is a main and ground terminal. Then discuss about the attenuator and isolator block. Once the channel 1 and channel 2 gives the input to the attenuator and isolator, it is provided to the electronic switch, and by means of electronic switch we are getting the signal in terms of the display. Now if we can categorize the external trigger input, channel 1, channel 2, it provided to the slope block, it given to the filter, and ramp generator generate that output. Depending upon the sweep and the XY generator, the position of the display will decide which signal is to be displayed. So this is all about the power scope. Now if we are consider about the general features of the power scope, so general features of the power scope are as follows. The first feature of the power scope is it has wide range of measurement. The second one is the compact design. The design of power scope is a compact. It is a lightweight power scope. Then high degree of operator safety. The safety of the operator is the most important point. So these are the general feature of the power scope. So if there is a question in the exam, NSEM examination, explain the block diagram and working principle of power scope. Draw this diagram and you have to explain these few points. Now if we deal with some working, the input is attenuated by a factor of 20. The input does not have the ground terminal, which is have in a conventional oscilloscope. The vertical input range, as we discussed earlier, is 50 millivolt per division to the 500 volt per division. The trace is sandwiched in two channels at the rate of 100 kilohertz. That is what is the issue of the ground terminal that is not face in a power scope. We are give the two input terminal at channel 1 and channel 2. The AC mode bandwidth is 2 hertz to 15 megahertz. It have a wide range of measurement, then compact design, lightweight and high safety. Now the next topic in this unit is power supply. The power supply, as the diagram shown, the power supply is consist of transformer, rectifier, smoothing circuit, regulator and load. So we have to discuss this power supply one by one. But before going to start the power supply explanation, why this power supply required? So all the electronic circuit needs a DC voltage for their operation. The DC supply voltage is derived from the single phase AC main circuit. And how this supply is derived is known by using the power supply. The block diagram of power supply is shown. So it consists of a transformer. So the transformer is a step down transformer, a rectifier circuit, a filter, or you can say a smoothing circuit is provided, a voltage regulator and the load circuitry. So how the working of power supplies take place? The AC mains voltage is applied to a transformer, which is a step down transformer. It reduces the amplitude of AC voltage and applies it to the rectifier. The rectifier is usually bridge type full wave rectifier. It converts the AC voltage into the pulsating DC voltage. The ripple in the pulsating DC is reduced by the filter or by means of the smoothing circuit as shown in the block diagram, which is connected after the rectifier. And the filter can be of C type filter, L type filter, LC type filter or CLC type of filter. The output of the filter or the smoothing circuit is a smooth DC voltage with a small ripples. And the combination of transformer, rectifier and filter is called as unregulated power supply. So the output of this unregulated power supply is connected at the input of the regulator, which is known as a voltage regulator circuit. The voltage regulator is a specially designed circuit to keep the output voltage constant. The voltage regulator circuit can be either a series voltage regulator or shunt voltage regulator. And therefore, the output voltage is provided to the load, which is obtained from the voltage regulated circuit. So this is all about a constant supply we obtain from the AC mains supply. Even though the output voltage V0 of the regulated power supply remains absolutely constant, practically it does not remain constant. So it changes slightly due to changes in certain parameters such as load current, input voltage or temperature. Thus, we get a constant DC voltage at the output of the regulated DC power supply, which is fed to the load. In the block diagram, with each block, how the waveforms are getting changed, these are also shown. If there is a question for explain the block diagram of power supply in detail, then you have to draw a block, that is transformer, rectifier, filter or a smoothing circuit, regulator and load. And below of that, each and every block, you have to draw these waveforms also. So So waveforms, input waveform is a simple sinusoidal because it 230 volt AC supply. Then transformer output is given, it is a step down transformer, so magnitude of that AC voltage is getting reduced. Then the, it's provided to the rectifier, so rectifier gives you, it is a full wave rectifier for both the half cycle, for positive half cycle as well as for negative half cycle, you will get the output, and that rectified output is shown in the diagram. Then the filter output, the ripples are, few ripples are present in the filter output. Instead of a constant DC, we'll get some ripples, and these ripples are getting vanished, means you get the perfect DC voltage after the regulator circuit. Practically, it's not possible, in but in the waveform, you have to show a constant DC, that is a straight line, which is shown in the last waveform, that is a pure DC output voltage. So this is all about the power supply. So this is all about the power supply. Now the step down transformer reduces the main supply voltage, rectifier circuit converts bidirectional current to the unidirectional current, filter circuit reduces the ripples and makes it smooth DC, then voltage regulator keeps the load voltage constant against the changes due to the supply voltage or the load current. Two types of regulators may be used, linear regulator or a switching regulator. Then regulator also rejects ripples and converts smooth DC to the pure DC. Now we are discussing this type of power supply is a fixed output voltage DC power supply. However, there are many other types of the power supplies are also available. So what are these power supplies? So first one is a single polarity variable output DC supply. Dual polarity fixed output DC power supply. Dual polarity variable output DC power supply. These all are the types of power supply. But if there is a question from unit number 4 on a power supply, then you have to explain the diagram which already we discussed in detail. Describe each and every block in a detail. Describe these waveforms. Then what are the peculiar working of your power supply, that you have to be discussed. So only that much is required for the power supply topic as per the exam point of view. Now we start the next topic of unit number 4, that is auto transformer. Maybe again the question is on auto transformer. So what is mean by the auto transformer? So an auto transformer is a special type of transformer such that a part of the winding is common to both primary as well as secondary. It has only winding wound on a laminated magnetic core. With the help of the auto transformer, the voltage can be stepped down or can be stepped up also to any desired value. Now, as shown in the figure, the primary winding and secondary winding both are utilized from the main same winding. So, as shown in the figure, PR acts as a primary winding while part of the primary winding, that is RQ or you can say QR, acts as a secondary winding. The position of Q is called as a percent tapping point, and this tapping point can be selected as per the requirement of the secondary voltage. So this is all about the construction of the auto transformer, and as we can say, it is a step down transformer as shown in the figure. Now if we can observe the working principle, the operating principle of the auto transformer is same as that of the two winding transformer. Now if we consider a step down transformer as we discussed earlier, that is PR is a primary winding, RQ or QR is a secondary winding and point Q is a percent tapping point. Then the actually the working is happen in the fashion such a that the current in the portion QR or RQ, that is in the secondary, in case of a step down auto transformer, is the vector difference of current I2 and I1. So this is all about the auto transformer. Now if we go for the detailed working of the auto transformer, as usual, it consists of only single winding, which is common to both primary and secondary. It has two end terminal act as a primary and one end terminal, and intermediate terminal Q acts as a secondary winding. The position of the intermediate terminal Q determines whether the auto transformer works as a step down transformer or step up transformer. The theory operation of the autotransformer is similar to that of conventional two-winding transformer. The autotransformer is cheaper than the ordinary transformer because of a single winding uses less copper than the two-winding. Since the voltage or turn is equal in both winding, the voltage developed across each winding depends on the number of turns. So this is all about the autotransformer. Now if we go for the advantages of the autotransformer, the advantages of the autotransformer are as follows. The first advantage is copper required is very less as compared to the conventional autotransformers. Ordinary transformer. The efficiency is higher compared to two winding transformer. This is also the main advantage of your autotransformer. The size and hence cost is less compared to two winding transformer. The copper losses, that is I square R, are less. Due to the less resistance and leakage reactance, the voltage regulation is superior than the two winding transformer. So these all are about the advantages of the autotransformer. And the next one is applications of autotransformer. So what are the applications of the autotransformer? Used for a starting of synchronous motor and induction motor. So in many applications where induction motors or different synchronous motors are used, starting is the main important task. So for starting purpose, the autotransformer is used. It is also used as a dimmer stack. So means in a step by step, you can increase the voltage. It is used as a furnace transformer. Again, it is used as a laboratory equipment and light dimmer. It is the best application used as a dimmer stat. So these all are about the autotransformer application. So far in this second lecture of our unit number 4, we covered the different block diagrams. So first of all, we can cover a power scope. As we discuss the power scope, and we also discuss what is the differences between the power scope and your ordinary oscilloscope. So we'll go with the block diagram of the power scope, what is exactly the working of the power scope, and what is the difference between the previous simple oscilloscope and what is the difference between your actual working of the power scope. Then we started with the power supplies. So always the electronic equipment, if required a constant DC voltage, then definitely we convert the AC voltage into the DC. So that's why we'll require the power supply. Then we'll deal with that power supplies also. So this is regarding to the power supply, its main blocks, that is how the transformer works, how the rectifier, then smoothing circuit, regulator circuit, and how the these waveforms are getting explained one by one. Then we'll deal with the autotransformer, what is exactly the role of the autotransformer, how this autotransformer is used as a step up transformer as well as step down transformer. Then what is exactly the working principle of the transformer. Then what are the advantages of the transformer as compared to the two winding transformer. And then we'll discuss the application. So far in unit number 4, we'll discuss about total 6 topics which are very important as per the NSEM examination. So starting from your first one, we'll discuss about the DMM, that is a digital multimeter. Then we covered the function generator. Then we'll deal with the digital storage oscilloscope in the first lecture. Now in today's lecture, we again deal with the power scope, then the power supplies, and now the autotransformer. Now if there is a question for the explain the block diagram and working principle, you all follow the same block diagram which are shown in the PPTs and go through the detail working of all that block diagrams. Now only 2 points are remaining from your unit number 4. That unit number 4's last topic is regarding to your analog DC voltmeter and ammeter. DC voltmeter and the ammeter. Before going to start, what about the DC voltmeter ammeter? we should know what is mean by the different types of the instrument, because this DC voltmeter and ammeter use permanent magnet moving coil galvanometer. Actually, there are two types of instrument generally. So that is a permanent magnet moving coil instrument and moving iron type of instrument also available. This permanent magnet moving coil instrument are also known as PMMC instrument. So this PMMC type of galvanometer is specially used for a DC voltmeter as well as for DC ammeter. So as shown in the diagram, it basically consists of the permanent magnetic set, mirror and all that. But before going to start this, we all cover this permanent magnet moving coil galvanometer in the next lecture. So for the 2 days, we have to prepare only these 3 block diagram. Okay, thank you.